Moving, it's an exciting time, isn't it? Yes, it's all so stressful. I know, I just did it. Yes, I moved. I hope you saw my how to pack video. If not, make sure you look for that. I'll link it in this video too. And one of the most important things to do on moving day in a city is make sure that you have reserved parking on the street for your moving truck. Now, if you have a driveway, kudos to you and congratulations. But a lot of us in the District of Columbia and Virginia don't. We park on the street. So when it is time to move, you need to make sure that your movers, even if you're the movers, have a place to put your truck. If you don't, it can be really problematic. You can anger your neighbors, you can block traffic, you can get a parking ticket that your movers pass along to you. Reserved parking is the way to go, and this video is going to tell you how to get it done. How to reserve parking permits in the District of Columbia for your moving day. That's what we're going to talk about today, and we're starting right now. I'm Sherri Ann Green with Coldwell Banker. Welcome to my YouTube channel that guides home sellers and home buyers in Washington, D.C. and Northern Virginia. So if you don't have a driveway in the district, you need to reserve parking spaces right on the street for your move. You need a place for your truck to go, whether it's a professional truck or the U-Haul that you have rented. You need a place for that moving truck to go. Hoping that there are parking spots available on the day that you move is just not a good idea. So how do you ensure that you can get the spots closest to your house, that you can make the moving day as easy as possible? You need to get reserved parking. You want to reserve the four spots right in front of your house so that you can make moving day as easy as possible. The way to do this in the District of Columbia is to get reserved parking permits. Properly posted and registered reserved parking permits, you will get up to four spots in front of your house on the day of your move, and even 2 days of a move if you need 2 days worth of parking. This is important for a couple of reasons. First, you want your movers to have as easy access as possible to your front door. It makes loading or unloading a breeze. Second, these moving trucks probably don't have the right residential permit sticker in the window. So if they do, by chance, roll up and magically find the four spots in front of your house available for them to park in, there's a decent chance they're going to get ticketed because they will have parked in a residential zone for too long. So reserving these parking permits is the way to go. The added benefit of having these reserved parking spots is that if someone does end up parking in that spot on your moving day, you can have them ticketed and towed. Now, I know that sounds harsh to be ticketing people and towing their cars, but when you have a huge container truck showing up to move your belongings, it needs a place to park. And these signs have to be posted in a timely fashion, which gives people enough heads up that they should have known to move their car. And you don't want to block the street, and you want your movers to have a place to go. So sometimes you do have to ticket and tow cars out of the way so that you can get the job done. So reserve parking is imperative, and registering those parking spots is just as important. You can print all the signs you want, but if you don't register the permits, they just don't do you any good, and they're not on file with the city as your actual spots for the day. So if you don't reserve them and you don't register them, you can't have anyone ticketed and towed. So how do you get all of this done? It sounds like a little bit of a complicated process, and in the meantime, you're trying to pack up your house. It can be. My best advice is to use a professional permit puller, and I'll link to the one that I have used in the comments. It will cost you a fee in addition to the cost of the permit. The professional permit puller will register the permits on the day that you need them. They will print the proper signs. They will post them in a timely fashion. They will register the permits so that everything is handled for you and your truck just has to show up on moving day. In the weeks leading up to your move, there are a lot of little things to do. So if a professional permit puller can help you with this, it might be worth the investment in their time. Now, if you don't want to hire a professional to do this, you absolutely can do it yourself, and I'm going to give you the quick steps in this video so that you can do it all on your own. Now, I'm going to caveat this by saying the District of Columbia may change their process. So this video is only good for as long as this process stays in place. It has been the process for quite some time, though. But the basic steps that I'm going to give you are probably what you would follow no matter if a little bit of the rules change. So the first thing you want to do is go to the Department of Transportation's TOPS website, and I'll put a link in the comments below. To register for a permit, you first need to create an account. From there, go into the system and register your permits. You will find that there are specific permits related to reserve parking for a move. As I mentioned, you can actually secure up to 2 days of a move, which might be very helpful, especially if you have a packer and a mover, or if you're going to pack some things one night and then finish packing the next day. Now, while you can print the permit from your house, you actually need to go to the police station to print the reserved parking sign so that they are on the official format and paper. Most of these reserved parking permits do require an internal review, so it is best to do this process early. Your signs have to be up at least 72 hours before your move, before these reserved parking permits go into effect, but it is very helpful to start this process about 2 to 3 weeks early, just so that they are in the system and can go through any proper reviews that they need in a timely fashion. So as I mentioned, these signs have got to be posted at least 72 hours before your reserve parking permit kicks in, 24 hours if you're in a commercial zone, but just use the 72 rule and you'll be safe. One of the most important things to do is to call and register your signs. Going through all of this and failing to follow those steps on the back of that printed sign once you get it from the police station is fatal. You can not ticket and tow someone if the signs have not been properly registered. You have to show proof that they have been posted in time, and you have to send that in. All the instructions are right on the back of the sign, but make sure you follow those to a T. As I recommended before, you can do this. I've done it before myself. This time I did use a professional permit puller. I just had a lot to do, a lot on my plate, and I knew that if somebody else could take care of this for me, it would be helpful. But if you want to do it yourself, just go to the Department of Transportation's website, register for a TOPS account, and follow all of the rules. Just follow them all to the letter so that you don't miss an important step. Moving is a big job, and pulling the permits is just one piece of the puzzle. I'm doing an entire series on my big move, and I hope you'll follow along in the journey. I've already done a video on the packing process, how I sort of prepped before the packers and the movers showed up. There's a lot to do on moving day and the weeks leading up to that, and my channel is here to help. I'm moving. Follow along on my process so that you can learn the tips and the tricks that I'm going to share with you as I go through my big move. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss a video.